So Breeze Bay.
No.
And now for our feature presentation.
That's better. And now it's time for me to do my sixth game of Wheel of Fortune for the PlayStation of my original run, in which so far I've won $618,625. Hope you all saw my Game 5 redemption, because I walked away with more than $100,000 in cash and prizes, including a $25,000 bonus in the bonus round. And we're in the Holland stage this time, and I've got Jay and Lee joining me, of course.
Happy autumn.
Yes, it is, and the temperatures outside are actually a bit pleasant in my area. Yes, I want to... Oh, wait, I don't want to format the memory card.
Keep your eyes open for the...
Okay, here we go. What's our category, Vanna?
This time around, our category is... Things.
Things, okay.
Contestant one, get us going.
There we go. Oh, not a good start. Lose a turn.
You give it a try.
Oh, dang.
But there are worse times for that to happen. Yeah, I know. But player two got a bankrupt.
Contestant three, it's your turn.
Okay. What a start we're having. And I've got a Diet Pepsi.
250. I'd like a tea.
You're not gonna get a tea.
Over to
me. Here we go.
And the, I forgot the F's.
Yes?
Do you know which version of the Jungle Book will you showcase on your site today?
Yes, the original 1991 Black Diamond Edition.
$750.
And there's a reason. There's actually a reason. Because I have had that copy in my collection for 6 years.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, get off that bankrupt.
And speaking of copies of the Jungle Book from 1991, there's been a rumor for a long time that certain copies have the feature presentation bumper.
Well, unfortunately, I have not come across a copy of that yet, although if there is one that exists, I would love to find it.
Well, I just hope that it's not a hoax.
I hope it's not a hoax either. Because so far, my luck's been equal to that of winning the lottery.
$900. We've got three for you.
I'm trying to get my hands on that free spin. Okay, here we go. It's going to go past. Let's do an H.
Yes, there is an H.
Okay. There we go, I got what I wanted!
And guess what, I found out that you still have the Obster 07 channel up and running.
My Daily Motion Obster 07 channel?
That's on YouTube. In fact, you still have your capture of the opening to that VHS with the name the Obster 07 on it.
The Obster 07?
Yes.
That's not my YouTube channel.
It turns out that that capture of the opening to the 1901 VHS is captured previously from yourself. In fact, TV looks a lot like yours.
Well, here's the thing. I have those exact same openings on my Daily Motion channel. I think somebody stole those videos from my Daily Motion account without my permission.
Uh-oh. It looks like we're going to have to give him a copyright strike.
Okay. Here
well,
comes the next
to be time. Honest... He's going to get a copyright strike anyway for some of those VHS openings on YouTube, so I'm just going to let him have his fun.
Wait until you see this fantasy prize we're adding to the
wheel. Even though he already stole those old openings from your previous channel, do you think it's worth rape carding him?
Nah.
Because I believe this situation is very similar to the Super Mario World.
But the thing is, those videos were stolen from Daily Motion, so I don't think I'll red card him.
Okay.
Besides, you don't hear me talking in those videos, so.
Sorry, no
right.
So therefore, I will not red card him.
I'll spin better.
Alright.
I'll just let him get his copyright strikes on his own. Yep.
I think it's unlikely because Disney is not interested in giving a hoot about those trailers anymore because the footage about making Beauty and Beast is so outdated because it feels like you're seeing footage from 2020.
Oh, yeah. But I will say that there are some of those VHS previews that have content ID matches for those some of those songs.
Oh.
So, yeah. So we'll see what happens.
$700.
And actually, never mind.
We've got one of those for you.
I'm trying to revoke my own identity from one certain channel.
Right, of course. See how I do the spin?
I'm trying to be somebody else.
Right.
$150.
Oh, let's see. Varsity something. Oh, I know what it is!
And by the way, folks, ladies and gentlemen, if you caught my, the opening to the second episode of the 360 Spooktacular. I want to bring up that the name Sydney in the opening that I made up and acted on my own, that was actually inspired by the name of a street neighbor that I know of.
Yes.
So, just to clear up the confusion.
There's one in this puzzle.
And in fact, as for people who I'm trying to work on since I've become, and since then, I made some updates to the script. As for who I want to cast in, what I want to do for my dream project, I don't know what I'm going to say.
I just landed on the diamond ring.
Yes, there is
yes.
Not only that, but I also have the $10,000 wedge sitting in front of me. Here we go.
Yes, we've got one.
One more spin of the wheel should do it. Spin the wheel. Ooh, not quite. Let's
discuss more about that opening in the 1991 VHS. Alright. That means that all remember when
Jeffrey
Katzenberg did some speaking in that preview? He now owns a 2-year rumor because he bought VeggieTales.
Yes.
Whoa, that was a toughie.
And what did you...
Congratulations.
And I showed you the redesigned characters
too.
Under Katzenberg's watch.
Yes, you did.
In fact, the changed eyes, mostly the colors, scared a lot of fans out. Making it think that they turned from friendly folks into creepy-looking stalkers.
Oh, yeah. So far, this game I've won $28,760. Not doing too badly. But yeah, speaking of Jeffrey Katzenberg and his appearances on the 1991 VHS of The Jungle Book when he's talking about Beauty and the Beast, I remember it from back in the day.
He was only seen from a couple seconds introducing wrestlers down under.
Yeah.
So, after stepping down from Disney, he co-founded DreamWorks, which eventually bought VeggieTales.
And not only that, but he found DreamWorks with Steven Spielberg and David Geffen, hence the letters SKG.
600. I'll try an L.
With David Geffen, he had very little movie on it.
Yes,
movie making experience because he's mostly a music executive.
Yeah.
Is there a name in that?
But I did know that David Geffen owned Geffen Pictures for a brief period of time.
Which produced such classics as Beetlejuice, Little Shop of Horrors,
Risky
Business.
Oh, yeah. Beetlejuice I actually have, as well as Risky Business. Little Shop of Horrors I don't have.
But did you know that since David Geffen produced Little Shop of Horrors, it featured the first works of dead newcomers Alan Menken and the late Howard Ashman?
Yeah, I knew about that. I've seen the movie, I've just never owned it. True.
And I heard that Katzenberg has welcomed Alan Menken back again for an upcoming DreamWorks project.
Oh?
Yes, we've got one for you.
I guess this is what happens when Katzenberg worked with Menken for certain projects.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
$3,500.
At least there's only one. Yeah, you did mention that, actually.
So does this mean that Katzenberg will no longer be the CEO if he does that?
I don't know.
I guess he wants to stay involved with the DreamWorks as long as he's alive and well.
Yeah.
He'll be CEO until he reaches the age of 95.
Yeah, just like I want to continue being the head of Aubrey Scott Productions as long as I'm alive and well.
$900.
Right.
And not only that, but you know how we're in the month of October and I've got a Halloween special later to do this month?
Yes.
I figured out when I'm going to record the Halloween special in terms of taping. I'm going to do it not this Friday, but the next one, which will be the 18th.
Right. And as for all the episodes of this particular, including the ones that are out already, as we're taping, we take those... between a month to a month and a half in advance.
Yes, there's one.
Yep, we actually recorded it, all 31 episodes, in September.
Yeah, with some episodes being taped in one day.
That's true.
Say, for example, episode 7, which is out yet as we're taping, this was taped at the same time as the controversial first version. That was
scrapped in episode 8. Exactly, ladies and gentlemen.
But we're not going to get into details because this is a fun video.
Exactly. We're doing my 6th game of my original run of Wheel for the PlayStation.
Right. But if you want to know what happened in that first version, I suggest a YouTube search Major Red Card Announcement and you'll see what we mean.
Yep.
We're going to add a $5,000 space to the wheel.
Okay, what's the category this time, Venna?
This time around, our category is place.
Place, okay.
Player one, spin the
spin
wheel.
Spin the wheel.
And also, when it comes to movie night, other suggestions for movies I want to showcase are
two,
Corpse Bride, also by Tim Burton.
I'd like to spin
Sweeney Todd, starring Jeff Depp.
Now, there's a couple of movies I don't have in my collection.
Have you seen Sweeney Todd before?
No. Sweeney Todd, I have not. Corpse Bride, I have.
Well, I intend to show that on Halloween night.
Great.
Because it takes place on Halloween and directed by Tim Burton.
Of course.
I just thought I had fun with some laughs. But when it comes to movie night, there are many horror movies that show violent and disturbing content like graphic violence, bodies, pop arms, and nudity, both brief and...
Yep.
And,
exactly.
For Movie Fright, that's the Halloween version of Movie Night. I only tend to showcase family-friendly Halloween movies, or movies that contain little to no obscenities whatsoever.
Well, I know a good Halloween movie I'd like to showcase on my side soon.
What's the name?
You talked about Beetlejuice earlier. I have Beetlejuice in my collection.
Oh, look at that.
But it's not a VHS or a DVD. It's a blank DVD.
Alright, player three.
You taped it off TV, didn't you?
Off HBO Family back in 2006.
And also, in that, let's go back to that Jungle Book VHS over there. You saw that the songs being recorded with that Into the Lions movie and Jerry Orbach, the late Jerry Orbach and Angel Hera recording in that recording studio in New York. It's sadly no longer there.
Right.
According to Don Hahn.
Uh-huh.
I wonder what that place became now.
I'm not sure. I do know this. Don Hahn is going to be doing some autographs at Disneyland on Friday, October 18th. I mean, I would love to go, but I'm all the way down here in Texas.
Yes, and actually, let me tell you something. It's really, I got to tell you something, why it's really cool that you want to show the 1991 edition of Jungle Book on my side. I used to watch this tape religiously back at my grandmother's house. She's still alive, happily, and she still has the tape.
Good.
I used to watch that version religiously when I was visiting my grandmother's house in Montreal, Quebec.
Well, I'm happy to say about the 1991 tape of The Jungle Book. There's this video rental store in Duncanville, Texas called Video Corner until it went out of business in November 1996. I used to rent that tape religiously.
And The Jungle Book is my grandmother's favorite Disney because that's the only one she has.
Right.
And she's a very nice lady. And luckily still alive.
That's good. But yeah, Video Corner, that would be like the number one tape I would rent there, The Jungle Book. While my sister would rent this movie with Martin Short and Danny Glover called Pure Luck, religiously.
Hey, well done. And how much was Omri? Also, in that trailer, we get rare glimpses of Richard White, who can see for a second with Howard Ashman in one shot, because he was supposedly recording Belle, too.
I think he was.
It was Richard White, and also in that preview, you get to hear a small snippet of the original version of Be Our Guest, in which they were singing to Maurice by Change the Bell the last minute.
Yeah, where you could hear Angela Lansbury saying, "He's our guest."
You go first.
All right. That is not in the final cut. I guess Bell got swamped in the last minute at the time they were making this tape.
Uh-huh. As for why they would do that, that's a good question. I guess they wanted to kind of make the story a little bit better. I mean, it's all mentioned on the Platinum Edition DVD.
Well, according to Don Hahn, the guy who came up with the idea of using Bell instead of Maurice is animator Bruce Woodstock.
Yes.
In fact, because that Howard was so ill at the time, I guess Woodside actually came up with those additional lyrics where, you know, they sound like you're alone and you're scared, but the band was all prepared, logically we were complaining while the flag was entertaining. Those lines are supposedly penned by Woodside at the time he was suggesting that Belle would be sung, Be Our Guest.
Uh-huh.
But Dawn said that Howard came up with those new lyrics, but I don't know, because having swap Maurice with Belle got conceived at the time when Howard was almost no longer around because of AIDS.
Got three for you.
So I thought Bruce Woodstock came up with those additional lyrics. Well, if that's so, why didn't he get the co-lyrics credit? That way he would have gotten an Oscar nomination.
We have two H's.
It's true.
I'll spin, Hannah.
And actually, some of the footage the people making Beauty and the Beast was actually recycled in the teaser trailers for the home video trailers for Aladdin. In fact, in the 101 Dalmatians VHS, the recording sessions of Belle and Be Our Guest were reused in the 101 Dalmatians teaser trailer for Aladdin.
I knew that.
Which is kind of odd because, how come they didn't get more footage of people recording Friend Like Me?
I guess they were probably still working on that song at the time. That's my best guess. That'd be Mark Elliott?
Yes. Imagine him, imagine if Casey Kasem did some narration of those trailers.
Imagine that.
Awesome.
Yeah. And that any day now, Aubrey Scott's Top 40 will start airing on YouTube.
As we're taping.
That's right. But...
And right now, we're searching for more eBay goodness.
Yes, we've got one for you.
Davy Crockett, Johnny Tsunami, Oof Troop, Paco Rosso, the original Frankenweenie, While Hearts Can Be Broken, Tower of Terror. It's getting harder to search for treasure nowadays.
It's true.
I wonder if one of these versions is super rare. Common. It sounds like I'm about to say Comic Con. I'm trying to say Common. Let's see.
The category of this puzzle is proper name.
And also, for foreign dubs of the Three Caballeros, and I wanted to bring this up.
Here I go.
The only languages in which they have their own set of translated lyrics for most dub versions are English, Spanish, Portuguese, Japanese, and Greek. However, for
speed up!
German and French, they retain the original Spanish dub lyrics.
$900.
Give me an F. I wonder why. It's because
$2,700.
They couldn't find a proper translator on time. I don't know.
Basketball sensation Michael Jordan. Oops. There we go. I had to correct my error there. That's more like it.
That's it. Want to see how you're doing?
So far this game, I've won $32,960 cash and prizes. Now a chance to play for something in the bonus round. I won the cash last time. Let's see what'll happen here. I've already got over 618 grand. Well, with that 32,000 plus, I have over $650,000.
And player one is going to the bonus round.
I think I'm going to go with a W.
If you'll just pick a letter, we'll see if we can't get you the prize behind it. Here's the category this round. Place.
G, P, K, I, peeking! That was easy.
Something tells me
what did I get?
Congratulations.
Oh, I got the cash again! All right! Twice in a row, I won the cash. See what I won this game. $57,960. Meaning I've won $676,585. Seventh game guaranteed. Catch you all next time, folks.